We're back on site at a commercial three-phase installation of our CTEK EV charger, and you can see behind us it's nearly completed. If you haven't checked out the previous videos, I'll leave a link for those in the description below. This time I'm joined by Steve from TIS, and you seem to have a mystery box there. What's inside our mystery box?
Yes, Gary, we've brought our TIS MFT Pro today with our TIS EV-TEST 100 to fully test this CTEK EVC charging station.
Okay, that sounds really complicated, and I'd love to step in and start obviously using the tester, but as you're here, Steve, I'm going to put you to work. And for the keen eye amongst us, you will have seen Ross in the background, someone we like to call the Bez of the electrical industry. No doubt he'll be out with his maracas at some point. And as it's rather cold, Steve, I'm going to join you with a woolly hat. Let's do a bit of testing, shall we?
Yep.
Well, it's not often you get walked through by somebody who really understands the tester, Ross, is it? So we're in a great position here. Steve, go on and start us off. What are we going to do first?
So we're going to turn the instrument on. This is our TIS MFT Pro.
It's the Pro Plus. Would it be the same on the Pro?
The Pro Plus is one will do a 3 and a 4 wire earth electrode test. Other than that, the MFT Pro and Pro Plus are exactly the same, Gary.
And we don't need that test for this, so nope. It does exactly the same test. So if you're watching this and you've got the Pro and not the Pro Plus, this will also help you then. So What screen do we go to first?
Yep, so on the third page, you can see we've got the EVSE test icon.
Okay.
So we click on the EVSE icon. And basically what it's asking us to do now in this bottom left-hand corner is set up the EVSE charger that we're actually installed today.
Right, so we've got to select the ampere rating of it as well as it's vented and unvented. That really means has it got a fan built into it or has it not, is that correct?
Correct, Gary, yeah.
Okay, so what are we set to at the minute?
Yeah, so we've got it set to three phase. We've got it set to non-ventilated and this is a 32 amp installation. So we've got it set to 32 amp and we can tick that box to confirm that EVSE is all set up correctly. When we press go on the MFT Pro, you'll see now it's brought up a screen to actually set up the first testing procedure.
So the first test being continuity test, we're not talking about doing a continuity of the CPC test,
correct,
which me and Ross did in a separate video. This is proving the continuity of the charging unit itself.
Correct, Gary, yeah.
Okay, so the leads are set out there for me, so I've got a bit of a help desk, which is what I like. So are you gonna put the leads in and just show us where we're going?
Yep, so you'll see this is the tester on here, and it's saying put my black lead into B1 on the tester.
Yep.
And on B4 of the tester, which we've done there.
Okay.
And it's asking for the B4 lead to go into the PE in the EV adapter.
Okay, yeah, I can see that.
And you'll see that the B1 lead is referencing to earth.
Okay, so we've got an earth reference. So it's slightly different on our EV this time is because we're gonna just have to open it up for our reference earth.
Correct.
So if I step into here and unlock it, and I just drop down my CTEK charging unit. Now, some things for you people, there's already a barrier here to stop me touching any live parts. The reason we can drop it down when in use, and not necessary for doing this test, is the fact that we've got our two energy meters as well as our two 32 amp breakers, and it might be a case of somebody of lesser skill than an electrician needs to come along and obviously read the meter or reset a breaker. I know we can pick a reference earth up off this bolt here for this first continuity test. So Steve, you want to pass me the lead?
Yep. Just want to say as well, Gary, on the actual dials on here as well,
you
see this is flashing, so it's asking us to make sure that the PP is set to NC. The CP state is set to A and there's no fault status on the adapter as well, and we've done the lead configuration.
And so when it is flashing, it means I must do or check something, is that correct?
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, so we've checked those, so I'm ready just to probe onto my reference earth.
Yep.
Like so.
So we tick the box and then we press go and hold for half a second.
Okay.
Continuity test is good, 0.08.
Okay, I'll just reiterate that for everyone. That is not the continuity of the protective conductor from the charger all the way back to the installation. It's a continuity test of the actual EV charger itself. So I can put the cover back up now, can I?
Yes, you can, Gary, yep.
Covers back on then, Steve, so I shouldn't have to go back in there again.
Nope.
So we've done the continuity test. What's the next test to perform?
Yeah, so we saved that result.
Okay.
And now we're on to the insulation test, which is the next in the sequence. We can see this is flashing again. So the dials remain the same, PP, NC, CP, A, and fault status okay. The only change is that we now introduce a new lead. So we've got three leads and this is the only time, Gary, that we change the leads from a continuity. Once we've done this lead configuration, we never touch them again.
Okay, so that was flashing red, indicates to me as the user I must change something. You're saying it's had another lead.
Yep.
So once we've added that lead in, the rest of the tests, same lead, same configuration.
Yep, so you can see here now that the actual leads in the tester, it's asking us to introduce the green lead into B3.
Okay, yep.
And it's asking for that to go into the PE on the adapter.
Okay, so we're moving a lead across.
The blue lead, which is in B4, into the neutral lead of the adapter.
Which I can see there, B4 now goes into neutral.
Yeah, and the B1 lead that went for reference for earth, it's asking for that to go into L1, Gary.
Okay, so that was the one that I was just probing onto the unit itself.
Correct.
We've got all those leads in the correct place. Okay, and now we can move on. Is that right? Now, just again, insulation test. It's the insulation test of the CTEK EV charger itself and not an insulation resistance test, which me and Ross performed in a different video.
Yep. So we tick the box. You can see now that I actually set up the tester to perform a 100 volt test, okay. Gary. We would normally test an insulation at 500 volts or 250 volts.
Okay.
But from my experience of going around the UK with the CTEK, it can be quite sensitive. So we reduce the voltage to 100 volts.
Okay, so it's set to 100. Can you show me how I would change that setting?
Yep, so we click on there.
Okay.
So there's the 250 and 500, and I've set it to 100 volts. Once you've set it to 100 volts, tick the box and it's ready to do the 100 volt test.
So I would probably check with the manufacturer. I could be testing this at maybe 500, I could do 250, but you know through experience this one is tested at 100 volts.
Correct.
That's a great piece of information for us. So next.
Yep, so it's ready to do the test. It'll do the first phase.
Ah, so as I look at that, that's between the line L1 on here and protective earth, and that's giving me the green thumbs up.
Yep.
Okay.
So we save the result. You'll now see that it's asking me to move the B1 lead that was attached to L1. It's asking me to move it to L2.
And again, a little cross-reference for me. The section down here is flashing, so I must have to do something.
Yep, correct.
And that was just simply move a lead.
Yep. So we tick the box. The test is automatic.
Okay, so that's good. Same result. Okay.
So again, save the result. You'll see now it's asking me to move it over to L3. Tick the box.
And we test this one. Will it continue on and do the next test as well?
It will do that automatically.
Okay, so we get the full set of tests and this will be the final one. And there we go. So is that passed?
Yes.
Ah, we've got a green thumbs up again. I like that. Nice little visual indicator.
Yep. So we save that result.
So Steve's in full flow. I just want to interject at this stage and think about that continuity and insulation test. It's really, really important, say, for a tethered unit. We know those leads lay along the floor, they get run over and all the rest of it. And that test from the tethered lead to the actual unit itself would prove continuity and insulation of that test. So I would suggest maybe, if it's an untethered unit, that you actually ask the customer for their lead and perform the test on the end, and then you make sure you have that continuity of that lead and the insulation is good as well.
And it moves on to the next sequence, which is a status check. Okay. You'll see that that's solid blue, Gary, which means that there's nothing to change on the dials.
Okay, so as I look at it here, I'm going to do nothing here. I'm just going to press another button and to get that status
apologies,
check.
Apologies, Gary, Matt wants to be an L1.
Ah, okay, so we're off to L1. So there was a small change. Even though that was blue, we needed to move that lead across.
Correct.
Okay, so we're across now to L1. And status check, just describe to me what we mean by doing a status check.
Yeah, so this status check, at the minute, everything in this EVSE charger should be dead. So it shouldn't be delivering a voltage and it shouldn't be delivering a current because the car's not asking for anything. So there's nothing plugged in at all.
Okay. When you say nothing's plugged in, we're plugged in here.
Yeah.
What do you mean by not plugged in?
The car's not plugged in. So the car's not actually plugged into the car. So the car's not asking for a charge. It's not ready to charge or anything like that. Everything should be dead.
Okay, so effectively nothing coming out of those terminals that are in here.
Correct, yes. Yeah.
Okay, I like that one.
So we tick the box. A small voltage, a pilot voltage, no current being delivered and no voltage being delivered. So the pod at this minute is completely
so
dead.
If I was to lift this flap up and somehow be able to ram my fingers into here, I wouldn't receive an electric shock, would I?
Correct.
Because it is not doing anything.
Yep.
Okay. Next test.
So we save the result. You'll see now, Gary, that the only thing that's flashing is the CPB and PP to 32 amp. So we move the PP state to 32 amps.
Yeah.
And we move the CP state to B.
So just to confirm to everyone, the 32 amps is because the size of the overcurrent protection device feeding here was one of the 32s, hence we're on to 32 amps.
Correct. The tester also confirms that the pin should have dropped in the EVSE charger. At this point, I shouldn't be able to pull the plug out, and I can't.
Okay, yeah.
Tick the box.
Okay.
It shouldn't be showing any voltage, but if the car, so the car now is plugged in, but not asking for a charge, and it will deliver 31 amps of current.
So let's think of this logically. I've plugged in maybe overnight, I'm waiting for a low tariff to kick in, or my app to suggest that I needed to charge at any point, so I'm waiting for that to happen.
Yep.
I'm plugged in, I'm locked into position, and I'm ready to draw the current, but I'm not ready yet because it isn't on the cheap tariff.
Correct, got it.
Okay, that's good.
So save the result. You'll see now that the only thing flashing on the screen is to move it to CPC.
So we'll leave the 32.
We'll leave the 32.
And we're just doing this one here, yeah?
Yep, so move that to C. And now the car is actually asking for a charge. Right. You'll see that the EV adapter, all the three lights have illuminated.
Yep.
And the tester will confirm that it's delivering voltage and current.
Okay, and as I look at the CTEK EV charger, that's pulsing blue, so that is suggesting it's charging?
Correct.
Okay, so we've mimicked the charging process and that is underway?
Yes.
Okay.
So we save the result. Now it moves on to the fault status, so it's flashing fault PE, so it's asking us to put an earth fault onto the system to see what the charger does.
So that means we have to change one of the buttons?
Yeah, okay. So we move the fault status at the bottom to fault PE. We can see that the lights have gone out,
okay,
but the tester will also confirm that it's not delivering a voltage at all.
So that's tripped out?
Yep, it's taken the EVSE charger out, so it's killed the voltage that we saw on the previous test, so it's not delivering no voltage.
Okay, so
and the earth fault has worked.
So it's disconnected, yep, that's good. Is there one more to go?
Yep, so we save the result. It's now asking to put an electrical fault, so there could be an electrical fault with the car and we don't want to send the charge. And again, the lights haven't illuminated, but the tester will confirm that there's no voltage and no current being delivered to the car. We need to move the dial back to A, okay, to reset the pod from the fault status that was currently on before.
And we see it's got a fault status on the CTEK EV charger. It's got this red cross, so we're looking for that to be removed.
Yep.
So we're now back. We've lost our red cross, which was for the fault status that we had in the previous two tests.
Correct.
We've got is that pulsating? So we're suggesting we're charging, is that correct?
That's correct, Gary, yeah.
Okay, and
we're illuminated back on the EV adapter as well.
Okay.
So now it's the next status is a loop impedance test.
Loop impedance, so this is full circuit earth fault loop impedance.
Correct.
Unlike the other tests that we described that weren't, this is going to do that full test, and we're going to need to compare it for disconnection, etc., of the overcurrent protection device.
Yep. Press and hold go. We get PSC, PFC, live to neutral and live to earth on the push of one button.
Just takes a moment for those results to come through.
Yep.
So we're saying the circuit impedance there is 0.15 ohms?
That's right.
Okay, so we'd need to check that against the overcurrent protection device.
Correct.
And then work out whether that's acceptable or not.
See the result. We now move on to a 30 milliamp type A ramp test. As you can see, Gary, that we stayed solid blue, so there's nothing to change from the previous test.
So this one stays exactly as we are. We're just going to do that ramp test. So the A-type ramp test, just describe to me what it's going to do now.
There's an A-type device with inside the EVSE charging station.
There is,
So hopefully we're not going to trip anything behind it. We're going to trip what's inside the EVSE charger.
So we're going to get the time as it brings up that current, on that ramp test.
So we've got voltage present. So it's not like an ordinary RCD, it's gone out at 7.5 milliamps, but it's gone out at 113 milliseconds, and we've heard the EVSE charging station, it's tripped with inside there, not what's behind it.
So we've disconnected the RCD element within the CTEK EV charger?
Correct.
Okay.
Save the result. A warning message comes on the MFT Pro to reset the RCD in the EVSE charging station. And we do that by going back on our CP state to A.
So we've gone back to A here, and we can see on here we've lost the fault status.
Yes.
Okay, and we're ready to go again.
And we need to move it back to C, so it's back charging again.
And again, we've got that pulsating battery symbol saying it's charging. Our EV adapter is now saying it's live.
Correct. You'll see on the tester at the bottom here, Gary, that it says DD 6 milliamp.
Okay.
So most EVSE charging stations don't put a Type B RCD inside. One's because it'd be too expensive, and also twice the size. So most use an RDCDD,
yes,
which is a residual direct current detecting device. And you'll see on the MFT Pro, if you have got the Type B, you've got the option, but also we've got it set to the DD setting.
And this is now going to suggest, when it's putting up to 6 milliamps of DC into it, is it going to get it to disconnect, isn't it? Because we don't want to put more than 6 milliamps of DC onto the A-type RCD that's within our unit.
Correct. Press and hold the go.
So we're going to put some DC into it.
You'll see with a DD test, it's very different from a normal ramp test. It goes a lot slower.
Okay, so this is pulsing DC into our device, and at some point we expect below 6 milliamps for it to actually disconnect the circuit. So we're watching for this to be disconnected. It slowly comes up. There we go. Okay, so we've gone in default mode. This means we've disconnected it. We put 4.5 milliamps of DC.
Correct.
Into it, and then we've got it to trip out. Yeah, really good.
Save the result. And Gary, that's the end of the EVSE test sequence using the MFT Pro. It's now brought up a menu, so we can actually go in and we could call this wherever we're working, and you can save that to the MFT Pro and then download them results that we've just done at a later date.
That was incredibly easy, Steve.
We tick the box, and there is number 30 stored in the MFT Pro, ready to download.
On behalf of me, everyone at the team at eFIXX, and hopefully the viewers, Steve, you made that incredibly simple process for everyone to follow.
Thank you.
However, let's say we're on site and we do get stuck and we've watched the video and we're still unsure of how to carry out the test. What other help can you provide us with?
Yeah, we've got our technical team on 01274 752 407. So just give us a ring and we'll help you out.
Okay, we're also going to leave a link in the description for the tester. So if you've enjoyed this video and you want to nip out and get yourself one of these, it'll be in that description in order that you can do so. But until next time, Steve, thank you ever so much for your time.
Thank you, Gary.